Success Insight shares the stories of the people with passion and drive who make things happen in the world. Here's your host, Howard Fox.
Hello, everybody, and welcome back to another episode of the Success Insight podcast. Our guest today is Patricia Love. She's a woman's empowerment coach and practitioner of neuro-linguistic programming and an expert in the emotional freedom technique. We all know Patricia by now because she has been joining us on Success Insight really to kind of peel back the onion, so to speak, on her life and specifically her experience and her journey that she's navigated. And this resulted in her book, which already has been published, Seen and Unheard, A Little Girl's Journey from Silence to Empowerment. Seen and Unheard has so many tidbits and avenues for individuals to figure out where they're at on their journey. And really, between Patricia's coaching work and, as Patricia likes to say, the diamonds can be found in her book. Just a wonderful way to make the life you truly deserve. And Patricia, it's a pleasure, as usual, to have you back on the Success Insight podcast.
Well, I'm getting kind of used to this, Howard. I'm liking this very much, coming back, because I just believe in what you're doing and also in what I'm doing and trying to help and support people on this journey in life, because it's not an easy journey. And it's a journey that we all have to take, and we all take different paths and we have ups and downs. It's important to talk about it because it's important to be heard.
Yes, it is. We all go on different journeys. I mean, we might cross paths on that journey, but everything we go through is unique to us, and how we choose to respond to it is an important factor in our healing and moving beyond, or do we stay stuck in the past? And what I love about your work, and especially your book, Seen and Unheard, is you recognize things were not right. And not only did you choose to take another direction, another journey for yourself, but now part of your career, your livelihood, your passion is to help others, especially women, really kind of take stock in the journey they want to be on and helping them navigate that. So such a wonderful vocation that you have here.
Well, thank you very much. Because, you know, it's so important that everybody realizes that they can choose. They really can. And again, I use that word often, and I love that you're using it, because it really, the word choose has this word of a feeling of control over your own self. When I say that over yourself, is that you are in control, because a lot of people in life feel that they're out of control. And by using that word choose, it just really makes you feel more confident. In this life, we can choose to change. We can choose to live a different life if you're not happy. We can choose to move forward rather than being stuck in the past, like what you just said.
When we make this choice to move forward, are there some pieces that have to be in place? I mean, we talked about awareness, self-awareness, social awareness in the last episode, but are there other facets that need to be in place so that when we make that choice, we are in a good place?
Absolutely. And it's probably one of the biggest ones. Of course, as we chatted about, self-awareness is just the beginning of the journey and acknowledging where you are. But there's a word which is a very big word, and it's a scary word for a lot of people. And that word is forgiveness. So many people hold on to so much negativity because a brother did this, or a stranger did that, or your parents did this. And it's a word that we need to talk about. It's a word that I don't think we talk about enough. And I mean, in fact, even when people pass, we need to talk about forgiveness, because a lot of times we didn't have time to work out things. And so sometimes we need to forgive those people. And then obviously the biggest one is we need to learn to forgive ourselves.
I really do agree. This word forgiveness and forgiving others, forgiving ourselves, it's a hard nut to crack. You know, heck, I'm in my, oh my God, 60s.
You're in great company, Howard.
I'm in great company. And I still think about my parents and growing up and the challenges of who I became. How did I become this?
Right.
So much of who we are today is really driven or predicated on what things that happened many, many years ago, that in some cases we don't have the ability to go to somebody and say, I forgive you. But somehow we have to introduce that into our mindset, that we're going to accept it is what it is, and now I have to move forward.
You're absolutely right. A lot of these things happened in the past, or happened, and they happen throughout life too, but a lot of the big triggers happened in your childhood, maybe your parents or relatives or strangers, or they've done something, or the kid in the yard that was bullying you, or the play yard. You know, there's all kinds of things that trigger things and creates the behavior that we actually result in doing today. And we kind of wonder why we keep doing the same thing over and over. And it's because of those triggers. The word forgiveness, why it's so important, is there are people that are not here with us anymore. For instance, my father was emotionally unavailable to me. And when I say that, he did not know how to say, I love you. He didn't know how to hug me. He didn't know how to be that father that you want to jump into their arms type of person. He knew how to put a roof over my head and buy me things, but he didn't know how to love me. So in turn, that lack of love that I felt, now you might talk to somebody else and they would have a different opinion, but it's always how you feel. Okay. So as I grew older and I would try to get into relationships with people, I would always choose the wrong people. I would always choose people that were emotionally unavailable. And so it became just a cycle. So as an adult, I had to stop and start to become aware and say, wait a minute. I learned this from my father. My father's now gone. I need to forgive my father for being the way he was, rather than playing the victim and being mad at him and blaming him, saying, was it because of you I'm this way? That plays the victim. But when you turn it around and say, you know, I'm going to forgive you, father, because, or dad, because you only knew what you knew. You didn't know any better. He had a very, very abusive life. So we don't always know the stories, or we forget the stories that other people might be involved in. Here, another example is, and I'm only going to say this because there's a lot of women that have been sexually assaulted. And that's, for a lot of women, this is like very, very hard to forgive. Now, I'm going to say, you never forget, but you forgive. And the reason you do forgive, not only your parents or a stranger, that maybe, or somebody has sexually assaulted you, is because you're holding on to that negative energy. And in most cases, they're not even around to defend themselves. They could have passed on. You don't know who they were. They were never jailed. No matter what it is, you have to let go of that toxicity, because they also had a story. So I forgave my person that sexually assaulted me because I don't know if he was abused. I don't know, but good chances are is usually abusers abuse. You know, so it's a cycle, and you don't always know where he's coming from. He did what he knew what to do, because this is how he reacted or acted out. And I just happened to be there.
Well, question. I'm curious about the process of forgiving. I mean, not that we're going to share the deepest pieces of knowledge that you have in your coaching program or, you know, perhaps in the book, but how do you begin to help a client forgive, whether it's forgive somebody else or forgive themselves?
The first thing is I always help people forgive themselves, because that's number one. Forgive yourself, because you're human. We make mistakes. We're going to continue to make mistakes. In fact, I usually forgive myself once a day. I probably, because I made a mistake. You know? It's like, oops, shouldn't have done that. I forgive myself. And, you know, so we just have to realize that we're human, that we make mistakes. Forgiving others, especially if it's abuse or something that's very difficult, is not always the easiest. And I tell people all the time, there is no timeline on forgiveness necessarily, but you need to start the process. And the process basically is, first off, writing down who that person is that you want and need to forgive. You need to write it down, because otherwise it's just kind of out in the, you know, ether and just kind of romping around. And you need to be very specific. So when you write it down, I ask the person, and I did this with my own too. I would write down every person or everything that I felt I needed to forgive. And there was the bullies, there was the sexual assault, there was the parents, there was my sister for leaving me. I felt because she died, you know, that she left me. And so the first thing you do is write it down, The second thing is you go through each name and you say, so-and-so, I forgive you because you know not what you do. And it's a lot of ways it comes from, depending if people are religious or not religious. I am more spiritual, but I do come from a Catholic background. That's kind of what Jesus on the cross said. And again, I'm not, you know, talking about religion here necessarily, but it's you're forgiving people because they know not what they do. You don't know their story. And then you keep doing this daily. And if you have to, I actually hit some pillows. I took some pillows and say, you know what? I can't believe you did this to me. And, you know, you have to get out the feeling, the grief, the energy that you've been holding on to and compartmentalizing for so many years. You need to exert and get that toxic energy out of you. And sometimes, depending on what it is, it can be very shameful and you don't want to tell anybody or talk about it, but you must get it out. And it's just like a big release when you can take a pillow and take another pillow and start hitting that pillow and calling that pillow by that particular name and saying, you did this, you did that. I can't believe you left me, my sister, my, you know, all of a sudden you start to feel better. Now you may have to do this several times and then you start seeing that you're lessening and lessening the energy that surrounds forgiveness because it's a very heavy one or can be.
Very much. And, you know, I'm curious in this concept of forgiveness. Are you familiar with, and I know I'm going to mess up how it's pronounced, Ho'oponopono?
Yes.
The Hawaiian prayer?
Yes, I am.
Okay. I love it. And for our listeners, it's a Hawaiian prayer. It essentially goes, I'm sorry. Please forgive me. Thank you. I love you. And I remember when I learned this during a training program I was in, I was like, oh, wow. And because then I literally was thinking about at the time relationships and all the relationships I had that I was a self-sabotager. And so I literally went down the entire list of the women that I would go out with. And I literally, like for days on end, I would go through the list and repeat, you know, I'm sorry, please forgive me. Thank you. I love you to every one of those.
Yes. And it makes a difference. And that's exactly what I ask my clients to do. And I ask myself to do. It's one of those things by doing it and releasing it, you release that energy that's been holding you back because people don't realize that hatred is one of the worst energies in the world that stagnates you and just holds you. And it's like sucks every good cell out of your body almost. And it just, it's toxic and makes you sick.
And it stays with you. The toxicity from fear, from anger, from hatred, it stays in, it flows through our system for a long period of time. You know, the positive stuff, the oxytocin and the good stuff. I mean, that's fleeting. It's powerful, but it's fleeting. But the bad stuff sticks with us.
And it's a known fact, is stress, because if you don't forgive and you have really negative energy like that that you're holding on to, becomes stressful and anxiety and everything like that actually causes sickness.
Yeah.
And so you're not as healthy as you could be, where when you release this hatred, and again, I want to really be specific about this. I'm not saying to forget about it. I'm just saying release it because it's holding on to you and it's not doing anything for you. And it's not making the other person upset because they don't even know about it. They probably don't even know you don't like them.
Right.
You know? And they don't, and half of them don't care.
Yeah.
And so we just have to move forward and say, look, I'm not going to forget this. I'm going to be smart next time or whatever, but I'm going to release this energy because I'm not going to allow this energy to hold me back because that's exactly what it's doing. It holds people back from fabulous relationships. It holds people back from moving forward in their careers because they have this uptake of anger in them. And you may not even realize it until you release it. And when I released mine, it was, I literally was so emotional about it. I was crying. That's how much I had held on to it. So it's so important to just start. And again, and you may have a lot of people to forgive. Like I had a lot of people to forgive. One at a time, a little bit every day, you work on it and just being aware of it and making decision and choosing to move forward in your life because you're going to release this hatred and this negative energy and forgive these other people because they know not what they do. and you can move forward much easier. And again, you can do the prayer, you know, I love you, thank you, and the such. It's amazing how it works.
Yeah, and it's powerful, and it's such an important facet of moving our lives forward and living a life of abundance and having the things we want in our lives, whatever those are. For me, it's health, it's love, companionship, and nature. But we have to acknowledge what we need to leave behind. And as you said, we don't forget it, but we do forgive because it's no longer serving us.
You're forgiving for you, not them.
Right. Definitely that. Fantastic. Very powerful episode today and really continuing to, again, peel back the onion on this journey that you've been on and how you are helping to take our listeners and your clients towards a life of abundance and of happiness and really feeling like they are really taking charge and making choices that is of their choosing. So another wonderful episode. Thank you so much, Patricia.
Thank you for having me. I love being here as usual.
Fantastic. Now, before we leave, once again, if our listeners would like to learn more about you and your work, where are the best places for them to go?
Well, first of all, I want to tell the listeners I am an open book. So anything, if they have questions, I'm more than happy to answer questions. But you can contact me at patricialove.com. That's the best way. Or you can certainly DM me at my Facebook at Patricia Love, the rah-rah coach. That's R-A-H-R-A-H coach. Or Instagram, you can DM me too at the coach Patricia Love. And again, I'm an open book and my whole life is about supporting.
Fantastic. Well, once again, Patricia, thank you. And we look forward to having you on future episodes of the Success Insight podcast as we continue to create the foundation for this journey that you're taking your clients and hopefully perhaps even some of our listeners on to make a life of their choosing. So thank you so much.
Thanks again.
All right, folks, we have just been chatting with Patricia Love. She is our women's empowerment coach, and we have been building upon her recently published book, Seen and Unheard, A Little Girl's Journey from Silence to Empowerment. And today's episode, a very powerful one, was Learning to Forgive and some great anecdotal stories. And it was reminding me of Ho'oponopono. I think I'm pronouncing that right. I'm sorry. Please forgive me. Thank you. I love you. And definitely that is just one element or technique to really pursue this act of forgiveness, whether you're forgiving someone else, but also to forgive yourself. I hope you found today's episode insightful. Let us know what you think by visiting us on successinsightpodcast.com. You can leave a comment. You can also find us on our Facebook and LinkedIn pages, Success Insight Podcast as well. We are on the major podcasting platforms, Google Podcast, Apple Podcast, Amazon Music, Spotify, Pandora, iHeartRadio, and we are also on LinkedIn. Okay, folks, wherever you are, whatever you're doing, go out there, have a phenomenal day. Take care of yourselves, your family, practice social distancing, continue to wear your mask, and we will see you on the next episode of the Success Insight Podcast. Take care now.
Success Insight is a production of Fox Coaching and First Story Strategies. Find us online, successinsightpodcast.com.